right, there we go. We're live. I did not announce this, guys, as, you know what, let me, can I flip this around? That way I can see you guys. Let me get this set up here. I hope it doesn't flip while I'm getting set up. There we go. All right. I figure we'll put that right there, and anybody who wants to join the live stream can watch me flip it over to 5,000, hopefully, today. Oh, hold on. Getting it set so we can do both that and I can do dishes. Hi, everyone who's here. I will have to try to see this when it comes up as far as your chats. I cannot read them. It is too far away for me. Let's see if we can do this while, oh, I just lost a subscriber, so maybe we've got time. Let me get in here just a second. You're gonna watch me use the computer here really quick. It's funny, I lost a subscriber. Okay, hold on. Let me get this pulled up. Just a second, guys. And let's see, there should be. Casey did this for me last time. Let's see, so that I can maybe see the chat when this is done. What is going on? Why can't I scroll? Oh, it's like frozen right now. That's why. Sorry, hang on. I want to get where I can see your chat, but my computer is frozen up on that screen. And I lost another one. Awesome. So turns out this live stream was a great idea. Let's try refreshing it. I love it. Oh, up, it's down. Where is the screen? You can see how smart I am at this, right? Let me refresh this again, maybe. Maybe there's too much going on my internet right now, trying to stream and scroll this page. It will not let me scroll the page for some reason. All right, I guess we'll just leave it at that. We'll see if we can hit 5,000 subscribers by the time I get these dishes done, which there's not very many. Kids are both gone to school. I so apologize. Let's see. Hello for, oh, it went away. I couldn't read it in time. Hello! It disappears before I can read it. Yeah, the kids are both headed off to school. Casey worked from home this morning, so we had to stay pretty quiet because she had some important business going on over here at the kitchen table. So we had to hide out downstairs for a while. And besides, Dominic was being quite the handful today. I tell you, I think he's going through some mental leaps because he's almost like he's drunk or something sometimes. And he can't control himself as far as, you know, what he's saying. He's just being overly silly and almost like he's trying to get in trouble, which is understandable. He's, you know, he's five, his brain's going through all kinds of jumps, learning how to, you know, learning new skills, basically. That's always a funny one. If you watch this channel, you know that Casey doesn't do the cooking. She's not, wow, I'm just losing them left and right. Well, whatever. If you're gone, you're gone. You don't like it, doesn't bother me. But if you do, it makes me real happy. what was I saying? Lost what I was saying, doing dishes here. Oh, thank you. oh, I know. Casey, with, you know, she's not, her skills do not lie in the kitchen, where my skills do not lie in doing paperwork. Administratively, Casey says that's, like, not a nice thing to say, but says, hey, they don't know what they're missing. That's right, they don't. Or maybe they do and they don't like it. Whatever, you know. Not everything's for everyone. I personally am a fan of vanilla ice cream, even though most of the world loves chocolate. People say, well, how can you like vanilla? It has no flavor. And I say, it has a flavor. The flavor is vanilla. So that's one that with Casey that always cracks me up, because she always chooses the knife. She doesn't choose the right knife to cut things. She'll pick a steak knife out of the knife holder to cut up a tomato, and I'm going, that's the worst knife you could use for that. She says, it doesn't matter, it's a knife. Which she has a point. So she cut up something small with that huge knife the other night. It's been cracking me up. You ever do dishes and you've got an almost full dishwasher, but there's just that one corner that you can still put like two or three plates in, and you know you should just start the dishwasher, but you just can't because it's not all the way full? That's the dilemma. I need like one more. Wait, there's a dish. It's getting full. Yeah, I can maybe understand why people would unsubscribe when you're just watching a guy do his dishes and waiting for a number to flip over. To say, same here. My in-laws bought us one at Christmas and a couple years back and use it all the time. Do I have a business email? No, I don't, but I, do you have, if you use Facebook, that's it. If you go on the fan page, I try to answer all the emails that I get through the fan page. Oh, they keep disappearing. That's why I wish that I could see the chat on this. Let's see. There we go. One more item. Once I get this loaded, let me walk around there again and see if I can get the chat pulled up on the screen so that I can see it. Maybe I can look at both screens. I would love to do this downstairs in my workshop, which, by the way, there's a surprise in the workshop. Mentioned they make their own once you mentioned vanilla ice cream. Oh, yeah, your own ice cream. Right. So, a friend of ours, basically, here's the story. When I started this channel, I originally filmed and edited everything with my iPhone. So this little tiny screen and trying to edit everything through the iMovie app on the phone. And then I upgraded to my MacBook, and that opened up a whole lot of new editing opportunities and a bigger screen for me to see what I was doing. But I've been wanting to upgrade to an iMac computer, which is a 27-inch screen, and I saw one on Facebook Marketplace the other day. And you know me in Facebook Marketplace, I love to find deals. Well, there was one on there, and I reached out to a friend of mine who does software stuff, and they deal a lot with Macs. They have their own company, and I said, Bob, what do you think of this? Is it worth the money? And he says, what do you want to use it for? I said, well, obviously to edit the channel. And he said, I have a bunch of these in my basement. I'll just donate one to Hope for Hudson. So we got a MacBook. We got an iMac computer, and it's down in my workshop. The problem is when I'm live streaming, it's so far away. It's like as far away in the house as you can get from our modem. So if you saw the live stream that Casey and I did a couple of weeks ago, and I went down to Hudson and how we lost that quality on the feed, it's same situation but worse because it's in the very far bottom corner of the house. So I need to figure out how to get internet run into that room, and then we'll be able to maybe live stream from there. Otherwise, I'd walk down there and show it to you. It is in footage that I filmed for vlog yesterday.
That's awesome to have
it. Yeah, it is. It's great. The village around us is incredible. But that being said, so I got that set up down there, and I was going to be doing this live stream from down there, and then I realized that the internet was so bad, so I came up here. What would be great is if I had all three computers sitting together, then I could run the feed on one and check the chat on the other. It is what it is. I am able to read these comments after, though, so I'm doing my best to read them while they're coming in. Hi all, that's right. Hi all from, oh, I'm sorry, I can't read that. Hope, I saw Hope. Lally Hope, thanks for joining, guys. I know that it's boring. I'm just here in the kitchen. Oh, it's on Facebook. So it's Facebook, and then I believe it's / see the sites. You should be able to find it. Same name as this channel, and you'll see I believe you see the same logo on there, and then you'll see a picture of us as the family. What was I doing? Something. Oh, I know. So I was going to make some. Oh, darn it. I wish I could read those faster. This was great when Casey was helping me a few weeks ago because I was able to. She was able to read the chat while it was coming in, and then she, you know, either answer or feed the questions to me. Anyway, I think I'm gonna make some meatballs because I'm doing spaghetti and meatballs for dinner tonight. So 1 second, I'm gonna run out here in the garage, grab the little thing of the sausage because I'm gonna add it together with this hamburger to make these meatballs. Hi, Georgina. Hello. Be right back. Hang in there. Let me know if that changes in the 20 seconds I'm gone. Hey, what? Turns out I was wrong. It's in here in this freezer. There it is. This is like the most delicious sausage. It's they put it on sale sometimes for like $1 for one of these little packs. I'm gonna get that thawing out, then I'm gonna combine that, and I lost another one. Whatever, you come, you go. I'm gonna combine it with half of this. This half I'm gonna use for probably some tacos over the weekend. And this half I'm gonna mix with that pork sausage. Roll it up with some oatmeal and some Italian seasonings and make some meatballs, fry them in the cast iron skillet, then throw them in the oven and bring them out. And then tonight I'm gonna make the spaghetti sauce and the noodles, and we're gonna have spaghetti and meatballs. Hey, I got another one. I think one of you is out there like unsubscribing, resubscribing, unsubscribing, resubscribing. Yeah, I thought it'd be fun to just come on and do, yeah, I know. I thought it'd be fun to come back on and do a live stream just trying to see if we turn 5,000. What's funny is if we turn 5,000, that we might jump right back down to 49.99 like we've been doing right now. Yeah, I know. All right, let me come around. Let me see if I can get that. both of us on camera here. There we go. Let me see. And lost another one. You know, that's the way it goes. But everything I've been seeing lately says the future of... I think I'm going to have to restart YouTube on this. They say the future of YouTube is live streaming. So I'm trying to jump on that because I am trying to grow the... I mean, this is my business now. I mean, essentially. Let's see. Live streaming. And it keeps freezing. I don't know why that's happening. Look at that up and down. Look at that up and down there. It says so many parents that abandon their children because of, I know it. That makes me so sad, and yet I still try to believe that people are good, that most of the world would do what I do. I know that they don't, but I hope that they would. How do I, maybe it's under community. Try that. Nope. Maybe it's under dashboard. I don't know how Casey did this the other day. She had it up and was able to read all of your comments coming in, and I don't know. And the only way to really learn to do this, I mean, I guess I can read, but I'm a learn by doing kind of guy. See, I'm a learn by doing kind of guy, so pulling it up and learning our way through is the way for me to do it. Okay, why is view on watch page? Okay, there's, all right, there. Okay, there's, all right, there. There we go, okay, I'm seeing you guys. Now, how will I look at both? How do we watch this and I see your chat? Turn that volume down so we're not echoing back and forth here. Let's see. Can I make this window smaller and then open Safari? And make that window smaller. This might work, guys. Let's see. Let's look at Social Blade on Safari. Socialblade.com. And search. That's the one. Select channel. Live subscriber count. Scroll it to where we can see it. Then go back to this page. Look at that. Okay, now to move. No, what happened? No. Went the wrong way. Okay. Here we go. Now to... There we go. Okay, now I can see your chats coming in and see the subscriber count. This is awesome. All right, going back to see what some of you guys said here. Let's look through really quick. Autistic Daggy, hello from London. Spike and Bob Adventures, yay. That girl Nancy, good afternoon from Canada. How are you and your adorable children? We're so great. Hello from Minnesota. Hello, Nicole McIntyre, Hudson, Diane Sellers. She's doing really good. Let's see. Hello from Rainy Texas. Hey, close, put windows you're not using.
I don't know.
Vermont.
I'm sorry, I'm scrolling through here really fast, just kind of looking for some of the longer. And all right, yeah, I want to see that 5,000 so bad. That's what we're doing here. Thank you, Georgina, for loving the videos. I love that you guys watch them. And yeah, I actually grabbed the wrong, you said add bacon to the meat. I actually grabbed the wrong sausage. I grabbed the pork sausage. The other one, in fact, I'll show you really quick.
It was the one I meant to grab. Oh, well, I guess I cooked it up already.
So there's the pork sausage, but then they have one that is bacon sausage, and that one is delicious for meatballs. What time is it where I am? It is 1 o'clock. There we go, let's see. Don't work too hard. You know, it's Friday, and I got a lot of cleaning done this week, so I didn't, I don't have a lot to do today besides edit. Facebook link in the comments. Okay, let me see here. Let's pull up Facebook. Oops. Learn to type, Dan. Learn to type. See the sites. Copy. And... oops, hit the wrong button. Paste. And send. There we go. There's a link. I hope that link works for you. Casey's so much better at this. I think when we live stream, we should have her and I together, not just me doing it by myself. So let's see, what can we do while we hang out and watch this happen? I know one, I was thinking about putting it on an episode, but I might as well just tell the story, which is totally just a random story, but I've been thinking about, I'm terrible at the question and answer because of the whole, we'll do question and answer here in a minute, because the way this is going, we might be here for a little while. And here, let me flip this around because I'm terrible at, I'll tell a little story and then, let's see, can you still see that? I got to come around to see if it's showing up in there. Yeah, there we go. I need like a big screen that tells the social blade. All right, I'm going to move this where I can see it really quickly. Click on that, then grab. I'm doing this backwards. There we go. Now I can see it. I'll catch up with your chats in a minute. Here we go. So here's a crazy story. When I was a sophomore in high school, and I remember it was February because it was right around my birthday. My father was a used car dealer, and we didn't have a lot. He liked to live pretty cheaply. So he had moved us, he had had an apartment built in his car lot, in the building of the car lot. And so he had an office in the front, and then he built had an apartment built in the back and in the front. Anyway, point is that five of us lived in this little tiny building that was my dad's business. So he was kind of like saving money on not buying a house, and it was a strange situation. But then he opened another one in Wichita, which is like 3.5 hours south of Topeka, where I'm from. And he was down there for more than a year. And my stepmother was back here running the business in Topeka. Well, so just telling a quick story. So it was really late at night. I was using the restroom before I was going to sleep. Like, we're talking 11 o'clock at night on a school night in the middle of February. And my dad was not there. He was in Wichita. And my little brother was asleep in his bunk. And our bedroom was adjacent to the office of my dad's business. So essentially, if we wanted to walk into the rest of the apartment, we went out our door and into the office, and then through another door into a kitchen, and then around the side of that and back into the back to where their bedroom and their bathroom was. Because, yeah, I've told you before, I came from some pretty trashy stuff. But anyway, I was using the restroom 11 o'clock at night on a school night, and I heard a male voice cough in the office, and I thought, that's really strange. Maybe somebody was returning a rental car, because Dad rented used cars to people. So I got up and I opened my door, and I didn't see anybody, and the lights weren't on, and I walked through the office, and I turned and I walked through the door through the kitchen, and I was looking. It was kind of dark, and I walked along, and it was like a small hallway, so I walked down a little hallway, and there's a door, and I looked through here, and we have like a laundry room, and then through there was a sliding door that went into their room. And so I remember thinking, wow, that was a guy that coughed, but you know, you don't think of something could be bad, I guess. And I looked around, and I said, Mom? And about that time, a guy jumps out with a gun in my face, and he goes, get on the floor, bad word, you know. So I mean, I literally, like, just slow motion in the movies, I passed out right there. And the next thing I know, he picked me up off the floor and was telling me don't look at him, and he takes me like by the scruff of my neck and was telling me he was gonna shoot me, and then throws down and puts a pillow on my head, and I'm thinking, I'm gonna die right here. I started saying my prayers, I thought it was all over. And then he's like ripping the VCR out and dumping drawers into pillowcases. And then he stands me up and says, you know, show me the way out of here. And I'm walking him out. And we get into the office, and he sees into my bedroom where my little brother was sleeping. We had some clothes in there that we were getting ready to donate to Goodwill. And and he says, wait, what's in those boxes? Is there anything I want? I said, that's just our room. We're kids, and we're getting ready to donate some clothes to Goodwill. And he's like, I don't need any of that. And he shoves me out the front door. I'm literally in my underwear with just my stepmom's coat over my head. And the guy hands me one of his two pillowcases, and he has a VCR and a pillowcase and a gun to my head. And he walks me like three blocks, and then finally tells me to put the stuff down and lets me go. And I ran as fast as I could back home. And then the police were there. My stepmother, at all of this happening, was in there with my little sister, who at the time was maybe a year and a half, 2 years old. And she was giving her a bath, and the guy had broken through a window into their bedroom and was robbing the house. And she had the bathroom door closed anyway. And so she had turned the light off, and she was trying to just, she was hiding in there with my sister. Fortunately, he never looked in the bathroom. I think it was maybe because he got distracted by me looking for, you know, what was going on. And so in the meantime, when he had come out from the bedroom and went into the office, when I heard him cough, my stepmother had run out and dialed 911 and left the phone off the hook and ran back to the bathroom and hid. And then, so that's how the police knew to come to the house, because they heard all of this happening over the phone line when he was telling me he was going to shoot me and all of these things. So it's a crazy story. I used to have so many nightmares from that when, I mean, all through high school and even into my early 20s. And so to this day, I still sleep with like a TV on. I've got to have some noise, and I'm very skittish. That's why I'm usually up so late at night, because I'm not, I don't know, I just get a little protective of the house. So it's like this crazy story that I thought about sharing in a totally different way, but I had thought of this last week, and I thought, you know, I should tell the viewers about some crazy moment in my life. But yeah, so one time our house got robbed, and I got basically kidnapped at gunpoint. That's some old life that I used to live. And now I have this wonderful life out here in the suburbs, and it's just so strange to think how parts of your life can be so crazy. And if you're in this place where maybe things aren't so good, we didn't live on the best side of town. This was something that would happen to people often. And I used to think I hated living there. I just, it was depressing. I didn't want to be around that. I had all this depression around it. But then look how good life became later.
Oh, darn it.
Okay, I'll make sure I get it in there before this is over. If you just look up See the Site spelled just like this channel on Facebook, and you should be able to find it, no problem. But anyway, but the rest of that story is that whatever it is in your life that sucks, that doesn't mean that it's always going to suck. That just means that it sucks right now. And the rule of our house, again, I know you've heard me say it a bunch of times, but the only way to it is through it. You've got to go through this hard stuff sometimes to get through it. You've got to journey through that terrible thing sometimes to get to that good thing. But sometimes you take that and you realize that things are good, or they're more good, because you went through something bad. You'll appreciate this current good even more if you've gone through it, if you've gone through something tough just to get there. They say that art is created through pain. You know, some of the greatest things, the creations in our life, are created because of bad things. You know, we have a space program because of war. I mean, that they created rockets because they wanted to make missiles and hurt people, but then it turns into something good to, you know, I'm just trying to get at a point here, which is always terrible when I'm doing it live, because I'm not as good of a speaker if I can't go in and edit all the ums and ands out of it. But I know that we all have hard times, and that's the reason that we're Hopesters, is because we keep hope no matter what the crap is that we're dealing with. We just keep hope that we'll make it through this, and we'll get to that next day, and that next day will be better. Because if you have the worst day, then I guess the only way up is, or the only way is up, right? So it's just, you know, hope, Hopesters. it's how I live my life. It's been hard being a special needs dad, but and that first, you know, those first moments, that first year was just, I didn't know if I could get through it. And I thought it would always be hard and terrible because that's how it feels when you're there. But knowing that I went through tough things in other parts of my life, that I knew there would be a way out of it. I knew that I just had to be in that moment, in that time, and realize it, and pay attention to it, and be mindful of the fact that you know, this what is that? This too shall pass. You know, you hang in there, and you just put all these cliches, but one foot in front of the other, and you step into that next part of your life. And you know, that's, I don't know, I'm gonna get lost in all the details of trying to explain it, but I'm so grateful for the life that I have now. I see a lot of times in the comments people saying, you know, that giving me advice or saying, oh, you know, this poor family, and while I appreciate the sentiments, I kind of disagree. I think our life is wonderful, and it's wonderful because we choose to make it wonderful. We choose to get up and be grateful for what we do have instead of being sad or jealous for things that we don't have. And finding our way into that gratitude has delivered more and more and more good into our life every day that we're grateful. Every day that we pay attention to how good things are, something just, whatever you believe, whether it's God or the universe or vibration or however you believe, it's somehow good shows up in our life the more grateful we are. Casey and I all the time just, you know, when something great happens to us, we go, wow, you know, like, come to think of it, we've been really grateful lately. We've been really, you know, happy for the things that we have. We've been focusing on being happy, and then good things show up. And on the days that we're being depressed and down and worried about how much work we've got to do, or you know, whatever, whether it's Hudson's sick and being maybe, you know, weak and regretful about that day, are the days that it continues to not go so good. And as soon as we put that best thought forward, that things start looking up, because it's all about how you're looking at things. But anyway, as I was going to piece that together for an episode, for a story, and it was going to be so much tighter with the comparison between those. But yeah, I remember it's a live stream, so I have to keep talking. But just whatever's hard in your life, just smile and go, you know what? This sucks. It sucks right now, but you know what? I know it's not going to suck tomorrow, because I'm looking at tomorrow. I'm looking at the happy that I'm going to have, and I'm going to look at how much I'm going to appreciate it when it gets here, because it's coming, whatever it is. You don't know what it is. It may not be the thing that you want and or think that you want, but trust me, when you're thankful for what you have, good comes to you. This sausage, I think, is thaw enough now that I can mix it up with this hamburger. It's so funny. We're just like up and down. This hasn't moved for a little bit, so that's good. I have this idea. Okay, so you know Casey's gluten-free, and I try to be, but I'm weak. But it doesn't affect me as bad as her. But there are gluten-free noodles, and you basically can barely tell the difference between them and normal pasta. Hang on a second. Sorry, the garbage disposal needed to drain. But one of the things that's hard to find in the gluten-free pasta world is lasagna noodles. And they're expensive, and they're good, but they're hard to find. But I've got this idea where I want to take and do a lasagna, but I want to do a meatball lasagna. So instead of just, you know, ground meat in there, I want to like do little meatballs and then stack the lasagna like a really tall one with like two layers of meatballs and then layers of the sauce and ricotta and stuff. I just think it'd be awesome to make like a meatball lasagna cake. So that might be coming in a couple of weeks. We'll see how that turns out. I, you know, could be a total success, could be a total loss. I do need to, I've noticed on the few food things that I've done that the lighting is really bad in here. So I'm gonna try to do better lighting and just better film work when I do food. I really did not expect it to take this long to hit 5,000, but we're staying on until we hit it. What's gonna be funny is if some of you guys start unsubscribing and make me stay here all day. Do not do that. I have so much to get done today. I cannot be stuck in the kitchen. In fact, I need to edit an episode today and get it out to you guys. So if you could share this live stream maybe and get somebody new to subscribe, that would be great. It says, okay, just give me a minute and I'll post the link. There we go. Shout out, please. I watch all your videos. Maddie Puppy. Yes. Hudson's doing good. She's at school. I will say she has been kind of, she's not been sick the last few days, but almost every day this week, and I want to say last Friday, she, no problem, Maddie. She she'll get home from school and then she'll be worn out and she'll go to sleep. And then I'll have her pulse ox on her, watching her sats, and her oxygen will be fine and her heart rate will be fine. But then her temperature starts to dip. And so I get her under an electric blanket and she's just out. I mean, you just can't wake her up. And probably a third of those times she's holding her pee and not peeing, and so I as soon as she pees, some nights she's peeing anyway and it doesn't matter, but on nights that she's her temp's dropping, as soon as she pees her temp comes up no problem and she wakes up and she's fine. So I don't know what's going on with her bladder. She's got a doctor's appointment coming next month, and so we're gonna look into some possibilities of what's happening with that. She was supposed to have a Botox appointment this week, and her Botox doctor's office called and said that her Botox doctor was sick, and so she wasn't going to be there today, so they had to cancel the appointment. So we did not go for that. They moved it out to the beginning of May. So in May, she's getting her Botox injections again. She gets them in her forearm, I think just one in the forearm, and then she gets like two or three in each hand to help, you know, release. She knows how she's in the fists often, and so she'll have them in the hands. Guys, we just sorry, I think I missed it flipping over. We just hit it. I'll continue that story in a minute. But guys, we did it. We hit 5,000. We're here.
What? Oh, what? Yeah,
this is amazing. You guys rock. Yes, 5,000. Woohoo! Yeah! Ha ha ha! Woohoo! 5,000! We're gonna celebrate with spaghetti and meatballs tonight. Spaghetti and meatballs, and you get spaghetti and meatballs, and you get spaghetti and meatballs, and you get spaghetti and meatballs. Now we're gonna have to stay on a little longer just because, I mean, we gotta make sure we don't dip all of a sudden, but that's awesome. Hopester family rocks. You guys are amazing. Wow. You know, what did I start this? In July of 16. So a little more than a year and a half. And it took all the way to October to hit 1,000. In January, we had a huge spike. I think we hit like 3,000 in January. And then I would, except I'm filming, it says I should call Casey and tell her. I would call her and tell her, except that I'm filming with my camera. Wait a minute. We might be able to do it this way. Hang on a second. Hold it. That was a great idea. I think I can FaceTime her from here. Da-na-na. Let's see if she answers. She's probably in a meeting right now. Okay, I've got to end this so that we can hear. There, it's dialing. We'll see. Like I said, she's probably in a meeting. Yeah, she can't. She's unavailable. Darn it! Trust me, she's probably checking it all day today. So let's go. Let's pull the YouTube back up. This is amazing, guys. Okay, kind of scattered brained all over the place here. Let me get to, okay, let's see, where are we? Channel? I think it's on channel, right? No, community. How did I find it before, guys? Live streaming? Is it gonna freeze up again? Oh no, how did I do this before? Almost there, let's see. No. Okay. Oh, no. How did I... There we are. Oh, no. That's... View on watch page. That's right.
View on watch page.
That's all right. Right. Turn that back down. I know it would have been so great. It says, that girl Nancy, that would have been cool to film her reaction. It would have been awesome to catch that. Ella Cook, 11 years old. Thank you for subscribing. I'm so glad you love the channel. Caitlin Guy had spaghetti and meatballs. All right, look at these yays and awesome. From Honeybrook, Pennsylvania. How old are Hudson and Dominic? Dominic is 5 and Hudson is 7. Hi from Ontario, Canada. Hello, Ontario, Canada. So let's see. Back to the Hudson story about Botox. Let me get back around here. Oh, arm and then in her hands, which relaxes her hands so they're not in such tight fists. And then she gets them right in her adductors. So because her legs, with her hip dysplasia and all that, her legs stay really tight for diaper changes. And so we need to be able to move her legs so that we can, you know, clean her and keep her comfortable so it's not painful for her to have that. So she's getting that soon. Shoreline, Washington. You, not as bad as it might seem. Hey, all right, that's good to hear. See, that's the positive Hopester attitude. We all have, some have tougher, trust me, but we all have some type of burden in our life. For some of us, that might be just being a guy versus being a woman. You know, I mean, I guess my point of that is sometimes just being you might be the burden. just being me some days seems like a burden because I don't have maybe some skills that somebody else has. I don't know. I'm just making up silly stuff to say. Anyway, and then what was the other, there was something else I was talking about. You guys have to help me remind me what. Hudson, Dan, Casey, Dominic. There we go. Hi. I missed the name on that because they disappear off the screen so fast on my phone. Let me come around. Jennifer Berry. All right. All right, so yeah, that's a good story for you. Somebody said, so when is Hudson's birthday? So there is some strange numerology that happens with our family. Casey and I met on 555. Oh, we lost one. Dang it, I told you we would. Casey and I met on 555, so Cinco de Mayo of 2005, and Hudson was due on 10-10-10, and she came about 3 hours early, shy of that, and a lot of that has to do with the abruption that Casey had. So it was she was a 3 hours earlier than her due date, so she was on time. We had a perfect pregnancy. I'm sure that if you're a Hopester, you've watched Hudson's story, and so you get the story for Hudson. But here's the fun numerology. So we really do think of Hudson as a 10-10-10 baby. So 555 to 10-10-10 is 5 years, 5 months, 5 days. Dominic was born, I don't know if any of you know this, but he was born 12-12-12 at 12 minutes after 12. Crazy. So his middle name is actually, he was going to be Dominic Benjamin Seitz. He's Dominic Benjamin Xavier Isaac Ian Seitz. We added the Xavier Isaac Ian for his middle names. Well, let me see. I'll give it a little time to see in the comments if you know why we added Xavier Isaac Ian. But 12 minutes after 12. But 12, 12, 12 is 7 years, 7 months, 7 days from the day that Casey and I met. And 5 and 7 makes 12. So it's some, I know, it's crazy numerology. And we like to do things in weird number stuff. We moved into our new house last year on 1717. So, yeah. So, yeah, I don't know. Numbers are funny. We're not some weird numerology weirdos, but it is funny to do the math on that. Let's see. Any more questions? Let's do some question and answers and see if we can get it back to the 5,000. How long have we been on here? Been live now for 50 minutes. Oh, my gosh. All right, if we can't hit 5,000, I'll shut it down after an hour of live streaming. We'll do it that way. I think that's fair. An hour of live streaming in the middle of my day while I should be getting stuff done should be fine. So do we have any more questions? Let me see if I can answer some questions in this last 8 or 9 minutes before we sign out. Caitlin Guy laughing. let's see. What other stories can I share with you guys? Oh, I know. Some stuff that's coming up. So somebody a few weeks ago asked if I had ever filmed a Domix story. And they made a really good point. Hudson's story is pretty significant. A lot of the theme of this channel is the fact that we're a special needs family. But you're right. I need to make a Domic story video. And to be fair, honestly, that's not going to be such a sad crying story, probably. Knowing me, I'm a little emotional. I may cry telling that story, but for different reasons. But I definitely, in the next couple of weeks, am planning to do a Domic story video, as well as maybe, I don't know whether Casey and I, we've talked about this, maybe a Dan and Casey story video. And then in the refrigerator, I've got a couple of more food things coming up. Let's see. It says, don't mind asking, is Dominic on the autism spectrum and does he have a speech impediment? So no, he's not considered on the autism spectrum, even though there are many days that he does a lot of echoing. He does repeat himself a lot. And yeah, he does. He may be on the spectrum somewhat, but so far no one thinks that. Teachers and school therapists, any of that. But he did have a speech impediment. He still kind of does, but he's getting better at it. He had severe apraxia, so he should have been talking, and he still was having trouble talking at age 2, and we were able to get him into a preschool because of his diagnosis with severe apraxia. Now severe apraxia is a motor planning issue with an oral motor planning issue. He just was not able to use his mouth. So he just did a lot of chirping and screaming because as you can tell, he wants to talk really bad. And when he wasn't able to express himself, then he was just screaming and hollering. And it was caused a lot of acting out. But within 2 to 3 months of getting him into the preschool with speech therapy, just leaps and bounds. But it is amazing if you go back and watch some of the first videos, like in the first 20 videos on this channel, you'll hear his speech getting better and better as you watch. One of them, I think it's the video Target Train. We go to Target, I think it's called Target Train. And we go to Target, and that's the one I always remember. He's pointing out the bicycles at Target, then he's going, buy tutu, buy tutu, buy tutu, because he didn't know how to say bicycle yet, and that he was over 3 years old in that video. He should have been able to speak. He should have been able to say the word bicycle by then. I remember it might be on my Facebook. It'd be fun to share it on here. But I used to try to get him to say vitamin, and he would say what was it? He would say. Anyway, I maybe it was by tutu. but he, we'd go, I'd go, I have a video where I said, okay, it's Vi, and he would go, Vi, and I'd go, T, and he'd go, T, and I'd say, Min, and he'd go, Min, and we'd do it like 5 times on the video, Vi, and he'd Vi, and he'd repeat it just fine, and I'd say, okay, now say vitamin, and he'd go, Vi-tu-tu, and just like, nah, forget it, I'm not going to say it the way you taught me to say it. But yes, so he does have a speech impediment, but it's getting better. He, right now, I think the only thing he's really struggling with are his R's. He still kind of has that W sound to his R's, but he's getting there. That's a really common one. If we really work on it and I make him try hard, he can get his R's really close to getting them correct. So we work on it quite a bit. I don't show a lot of those videos, I guess. It's such a struggle working with him that I don't think it would make for an interesting video, I guess, so I don't share it. Let me see, I think I saw a bigger question come in there. Let me see what that was. Okay, Caitlin Guy says, I ask, how do you do the glow-in-the-dark food? And, Fabiola Alcalde, I am so sorry I don't speak Spanish. I wish that I knew. I think you're telling me that you're signing in from Colombia. Gracias. Viva Colombia. I'm not very good with Spanish. But so the glow-in-the-dark food, let me get that out. I did point it out in the glow-in-the-dark mac and cheese video. But B2, just go to... God, we lost another subscriber. You can go to... what is that called? The GNC, the fitness vitamin store, and get some B2. This was really cheap. It was like $3 or $4 for, how many are in here? 100 tablets. And these are actually, they're fun if you crush them up and you can make stuff glow in the dark with them. This stuff itself glows in the dark. But it also helps with migraines. If you get migraines, take one of these. Alicia, our care nurse, looked into it and she found out that it would help with migraines, and she gets them. She said she stopped and picked some of this up, took one, and now she takes them every time she gets a migraine. She says it works 90% of the time. So if you get migraines, get some B2. All right, it looks like we're going down. We technically hit 5,000 today, and we're about 2.5 minutes away from an hour, and I said I was going to sign it out after an hour. I really appreciated you guys being here. I think there's maybe 5 or 6 days left on our t-shirt. Hey, we got one back. On our t-shirt campaign right now, so don't miss your chance, because I don't know if or when this t-shirt's coming back. But get yourself the shirt that says the saying, which is, to the world you may be one person, but to one person you may be the world. Go be somebody's world. Please go check those shirts out. There we are, back at 5,000. You guys are awesome. This is such a roller coaster of a live stream. Go get yourself one of those shirts at Bonfire. There should be a link in the description of our last live stream, but don't miss out. Because that campaign is ending in like 5 days. So there's a very short window of time to get yourself one of those shirts. So definitely, like I said, don't miss out. And also, if you're watching this, guys, click the bell icon right underneath this live stream, and that will notify you and let you know when I'm going live, so you know right away, and it'll also let you know as soon as I post if you want to get on and see the videos as soon as possible. Sometimes, apparently, YouTube does not share. If I post it, sometimes it won't show up in your subscription feed, but if you click the bell, then you're like kind of double subscribed and it shows up. What's that? Let's see. It says, what sizes? I think they go up to 3X. And yay, awesome, I've done that already. Caitlin, all right, awesome. You rock, thanks. See, that's a Hopester right there. But yeah, so guys, we're at the hour. Please please, if you're not subscribed, which I'm pretty sure everyone here is, but if you're not, please subscribe. Click the bell icon and, oh, hope we're still here. The phone's telling me the battery's dying, which makes for perfect timing. Like, subscribe. The liking of the videos is almost more important than the commenting, because the more likes, the more traffic YouTube sees it as. And the comments are always so positive. You guys are just the best. Sound like a YouTuber. The Hopesters are the best family on YouTube, truthfully. You guys are awesome. I've never seen more positivity in a comment feed than on this channel. It's incredible. And yeah, I love you guys so much. Like, subscribe, and click the bell. And with that being said, don't forget, to the world, you may be one person, but to one person, you may be the world. Go be somebody's world. You guys were my world today. You came through. You helped us reach 5,000 subscribers. That's awesome. I'm just one person, and all of you are a world to me. It's freaking great. So, thanks for joining me today. While I just stood around in my kitchen and did a small amount of dishes and pretty much nothing else. And with that, I love you guys, and I gotta go get a video edited and hopefully posted today. Bye, guys. I'll see ya.